Commence primary ignition.
Welcome, fans and collectors, to another episode of Binary Sunset Review. Today we're going to be taking a look at the GameStop exclusive jewelry set that came in tandem with the first season of The Mandalorian. Really high quality boxing. Very excited about this set, and I actually picked this up on a whim. Let's take a look.
I like those odds.
So first thing to note is the packaging of this box. It is particularly nice, a quality of a box, but also right on the top we're treated to the number that it was printed on. So this is a very limited release. There's only 10,000 of them printed, and this one is the 3,131st. So I always like that little added bit of collectability and exclusivity that comes with some of these packages, and I like when they have a little note to denote it. There's the reveal. Love that reveal. What a beautiful look to just the opening of this case. And I'm going to go into detail for each individual item, but just first impressions are how pleasantly surprised I am by the quality of this set. And here we have a better look at the interior and the display of this jewelry set and case. It really is quite nice. As mentioned on the front, we have a certificate of authenticity. These are always really nice, really well-created stamps. I'll do a close-up of this in but a moment, but just a really nice label and marking of the actual number that was produced. Quality. So this set comes with, as I mentioned, three props that were seen in the show. So we have the client cog medal, which was worn by Werner Herzog when accepting the bounty for the child. Next, we have the Mythosaur pendant necklace, and the necklace that Jindarin wears and gives to the child, kind of to denote his protection. Very, very cool, on a nice like leather strap too. And then lastly, we have a piece of Beskar that has been made into this pin. So here we have some really nice close-up of these particular pieces. When I open this, just from the moment I open the box, the quality and the limited editionness of the limitedness of this item and this particular just set is beautiful. A lot of us are rewatching The Mandalorian and just really finding a deeper bond and kinship with some of the amazing props and locations they had in the show. And so these are some of the most important just props. And as I started by saying, the quality of them is so beautifully high. Here we get a close-up of the certificate of authenticity. Pretty nice little added bit. We're joined by some of our Mandos I have in my collection. But just starting off, I mean, there's been such a lore and such a history behind Beskar steel and Mandalorian iron. And we, for the first time, really see it visually depicted in the show in its taken form, stamped by the Imperial. And there's a lot of just symbology of, A, this metal in the first place for Mandalorians, but there's also just added importance of it being seen with this kind of this stamp and this symbol. And it was scary when I first saw it and really cool, but I love that this set actually comes with just a brick of the Beskar credit. And it really does. I mean, Mandalorian armor has its own history. It has this all bit, but in short, the closest thing in planet Earth that we can kind of relay it to is Damascus steel, which is this special kind of steel that takes artists and hands to do. And when they artistically decided to depict raw Mandalorian iron or raw Beskar, they kind of had it almost match the look of Damascus steel, kind of. And I don't know much about it, so I don't know anything really about it, but that's what I think of when I saw this for the first time visually in The Mandalorian. And it was such a cool bit and such a cool added detail to make this metal just even more special than it is. Moving down the line, we have the Mythosaur pendant necklace. And I mean, this is really important. This was given to young Mandalorian foundlings when they're inducted into their clans. It symbolizes their attachment to the clan, to the tribe, to the idea of Mandalorian culture in general. And it's particularly important because the Mandalorians not only are warrior culture, but they're also a nomadic culture that has had over time bits or pieces, if not entirety of their culture, taken away from them. And I mean, as a person of color, we can completely relate to that, but as just minorities across the world and the universe, we can also relate to that. And just so there's something about kind of wearing that kinship and that pride actually around your neck and on your chest that makes Mandalorians so powerful and so cool. And it all comes down to this pendant they receive as children. Lastly up here is the Werner Herzog's Imperial Cog medallion that was either worn by governors or high-ranking people in the Imperial military. I don't know if I'm going to wear this one as much, but it's very, very cool to have and to hold, especially because Werner Herzog's character was such an incredibly cool character. The idea of the Shattered Empire was one of the coolest aspects that was integrated into The Mandalorian for me. And these governors that have turned into kind of these war tyrants on planets once the Emperor is shattered is a perfect depiction of the post-Empire universe. And I really, really liked it. And again, nothing is old power like an old heavy metal with the symbol of a dictatorship. Here's a closer look at the Mythosaur pendant. I am just continually pleasantly surprised by the quality of this set. It is heavy. It's a big piece of Beskar that wraps around your neck. And it's just very cool because it is beautifully flawed in all the right ways that we saw, and raw in that same reason. And it really does symbolize the connection to the Mandalorian culture and the fact that there will always be Beskar close to your heart. Here we have a close-up for the Imperial coin medallion worn by Werner Herzog in the show. And just the heavy metalness of this also. The ribbon is pretty nicely done in the black and white kind of Imperial governor's colors. And then this is like a pretty chunky metal. It really also has some weight to it. Is a thick piece and does weigh heavily around the neck and take up a good portion of the chest, as it's meant to. It's meant to be to show your almost kind of royal allegiance to the Empire. This was a particularly cool piece because it really showed the feudalistic kind of tactics that the Empire would employ in its colonies and its off-world settlements. Here's a closer look at the Beskar piece of metal pin and the certificate of authenticity. As you can see, this print is limited to a number of 10,000 here. That's particularly cool. I really like when they do this with limited series of things and kind of to let you know that it's a limited thing. The detailing into how the Beskar metal looks different from, you know, your average metal, your average Durasteel, it is really shown in how they artistically designed it. I mentioned before it kind of has similar aspects to Damascus steel in our world, so I really like how there seems to be waves through it. It's really, really an attractive piece.
So this jewelry set is a GameStop exclusive. It is only found on their websites. I don't believe they're going to have it in stores. Oh, you know what? I actually did see it in a store while I was passing through recently, but they are going to be few and far between in stores. If this interests you at all, if you're a fan of The Mandalorian, if you're a collector that really enjoys recreations of props that you actually see in the shows, if you're a cosplayer, all of these things are reasons to pick up this set. It's a really, really beautiful addition to anybody who appreciated or loved The Mandalorian first season. I'm going to leave links below to how you can pre-order your own. As I said, it is through the GameStop website. It does sell for $80 right now, and that does include the free shipping because it's over $35. Thanks for joining me, folks, for another episode of Binary Sunset Review. Stay tuned for future reviews and news. HasLab is going to be doing its big reveal this upcoming Friday. I'm going to be covering the live stream on my channel as well as a post-game that I will definitely open up to a dialogue for as many people that want to speculate and talk about what we might be seeing on Friday. Thanks for watching. I've been Mike. This is Binary Sunset Review, signing off. Have a great day out there. Stay safe, stay sane, stay awake, and remember, this is the way.
I'm just a simple man trying to make my way in the universe.